You heard my preamble about the mixed reality headset. What is this moment in Apple's history for you?
I totally agree with you that it's the big moment for Tim Cook. It's the big announcement of a new era, a new market. Building, though, of everything that he has done for the company since he took over the leadership, right? So I think we are going to look at opportunity in enterprise as well as opportunity, more opportunity in content. Those are, in my opinion, the two areas where the VR, AR, mixed reality headset is going to play.
The specifications, $3,000 reported by Bloomberg News, 16 gigabyte RAM memory. You look at the materials that are used to make it, but it really seems like the big question is what you can actually use it to do.
Yeah, and I think that's exactly the right question to ask. Right now, to be honest with you, it doesn't really matter in terms of you're looking at early adopters that will buy to figure out what you're going to do with it, even if it's $3,000. You're looking at developers that are looking at the opportunity to expand their iOS and macOS and iPadOS market. And then you're going to look at time before the mass market is going to be ready for it. So I think there's opportunity to create that ecosystem in the same way as Apple. You talked about watch, but I think a good comparison is also the iPad, where at the beginning you were using iOS apps and then developers came with dedicated app. I wonder if we're going to see a similar thing here.
I spent the morning going through all the data from 2022 for augmented reality and VR headsets, 300,000 globally in augmented, less than 8 million for VR. How much of a catalyst will Apple's move be for what is a young product segment?
Everybody's going to come, right? It's the classic build it and they will come. Apple has done that time and time again, right? Coming into a market that hasn't quite taken off yet, or it was, but then it stalled, and so they're able to re-energize that. I think from a developer perspective, there's no question that these offer a huge opportunity, and others will come to the market and see what is available.
Carolina, meanwhile, the rest of the market is just completely focused on artificial intelligence, it feels like. And there's a mixed viewpoint here from analysts that we're getting. Some, like Wedbush, think we're going to hear a lot about AI from Apple today. Others, well, our own Mark Gurman, saying this is not the time or place and actually wait for it in a year or so. What do you make of Apple's AI play?
I think that Apple has been talking about AI for a long time, but in a different way. First it was Siri, and then the talk around Siri went away, and it became more about on-device machine learning, which is still part of AI, is what still you need for AI. But Apple is in a different place compared to, say, a Google or a Microsoft, because they don't own their own cloud, and so they are dependent on others to run big models. So they need to bring us back to what is the value of artificial intelligence on my device. And linked to that is the value of artificial intelligence to me as a user. And there's, I would argue, no one else that knows their users as much as Apple does.
To that end, anything that you're excited about from what else will be unveiled today? We know that they'll probably be having an update to, well, the financial offerings, and it feels as though it's not a particularly pleasant place to be right now if you're a fintech and seeing just how much more Apple can own that space. What are you thinking about in terms of the health area? What excites you?
Yeah, obviously this is the developer conference, so I'm really interested in seeing what other enhancements all the platform from watch to iPad to iOS and Mac will bring. But we also know that there's likely to be some new Macs. And I think when I think about that in particular is the opportunity that Apple is continuing to have in an enterprise environment. You know, Apple never talks about the enterprise business. It's always a consumer company. But the reality is that they're gaining enormous share in enterprise. And if they are bringing to market a MacBook Air 15-inch an aggressive price point, then that share will grow strategically for them.
The developers love WWDC. It is for them. Watch OS 10, iOS 17, software. What are you most excited about there?
I don't expect big things. I continue to expect personalized care, if you like, the ability of really pushing, especially the phone and the watch, to be more of a health and security device. We saw last year some features. Those are the kind of things that I'm expecting. And then it'd be interesting to see what we see around messaging and FaceTime, whether, you know, this little fight with Android and RCS will end this time around or not.
Were you at Google I.O.?
I was not. I watched it from afar.
Okay, well, the reason I bring that up is at Google I.O. they referenced this fight in a sort of hint way. Go back to the headset. I'm sorry, we have to. Mixed reality.
No, totally.
But those developers in the audience, what is it that they'll want to hear? Because ultimately, we've reported at Bloomberg that actually the kind of core suite of apps on iPhone and iPad will be available on the mixed reality headset, but they will develop its next generation functionality.
Yeah, I think for the developers, it's all about the tools, right? Is how easy is Apple going to make it for them to take those apps that are already available, just, you know, regularly ported onto the, to make them better and to make other opportunity for them to monetize? You know, how much richer is that experience going to be for their apps that allow them to monetize more from the app?
Bloomberg is reporting that Apple hopes to sell 900,000 units of the mixed reality headset in year one. What's your reaction to that? Low, high?
It's hard to tell before seeing the headset and see what the value is. I think a lot of it will depend on how many different things can you do with it. From a, not just the app perspective, but from a content perspective, we've seen Apple really doubling down on sport.
I do think that is interesting, isn't it? Where this makes the most sense. Ed's great reporting, much has been said about sort of the Quest 3 that's just been coming on the market. We understand it's going to be about $500 versus the $3,000 price point that we're getting from Apple. But really where the penetration needs to be felt is in the office, productivity, not just sort of gaming and health. Is this going to be a productivity kind of a use case immediately, or is this ultimately just showing off that it's an aspirational good and you've got it?
I do think that there's an angle that is productivity related. We obviously see Microsoft play with HoloLens, but then walk away from it. So there's definitely opportunity there. And that's why I was talking about the Mac earlier, that Apple is now creating that space for them in business to be taken seriously.
I was looking at the history of WWDC. It wasn't called it then, but 1983 at a hotel in San Mateo was the first kind of developers conference. What does this event mean to you? When you sit there in the audience, it's pre-recorded, but you listen to it. Share with us your experiences and what you get from it.
I always remember my first one, which was after the iPhone in 2007. And it was a Moscone, and I came out asking if the coffee was spiked in the morning, because the buzz that you feel is honestly something that I always compare only to Nokia events. I date myself here.
R.I.P. Yeah.
Back in Nokia was the leader in smartphone business. There's nothing else quite like it.